This is Brigadier Atray from the Aviation Defense Service, and we have come from India to cover MAX 021, and I'm seeing that you've got a lot of new projects in plan and prototypes. I would like to understand exactly if you can tell me something about the status.
Airplane industry is looking forward to decrease emissions and fuel consumption. The one way, and actually the only one way to do it, is to develop and install real airplanes, hybrid and fully electric propulsion systems. That is very simple. It's like a Prius, you know, Toyota Prius car with a hybrid system. So the idea is to implement this same approach, the same feature, same approach, but to the air. Here you see the model.
You can take it for example. This model of the hybrid flight of laboratory based on the R-40 airplane. It's actually the unit and the probe to achieve scientific information how this hybrid system works in real conditions. This system consists of several elements. First, this is the turbo shaft engine, CK2500. It's a real one. It's from the helicopter. It comes kerosene. You may install several engines to the wing. Therefore you can realize the distribution of the electrical power at the airport. That's the idea. But when we decided to use these units to create engine, we have inside the superconductors. So that's a unique material which allows to generate high magnetic fields and fine currents inside them. So the specific power of this unit is very high. You need additional cooling, so they should be cooled down to the temperature of liquid nitrogen at least. But in this condition, they are really powerful. Actually, these pipes, they are for cooling. They're for cooling for the nitrogen. So nitrogen goes out, and there is a big part inside here. But the specific part is for this. That's what we realize now, and what is installed for the hybrid flight laboratory, which you have probably seen on the static demonstration. It's actually the same system as inside. But if we decide to use liquid hydrogen as a fuel, not kerosene, but liquid hydrogen, actually the turbine can eat it. The same units will generate 3-4 times more power, because superconductors, they liquid hydrogen produce no CO2, no CO2, it's only water, and it's very clean and free. And that's what the company said. Yes, and another one
they cannot fly inside the cities during the night, because people need to sleep. But this is an electric system. And so there is no noise.
Well,
it should be a little bit, because there is a turbine.
Yes.
But the part which is outside there, it will make a much lower noise than traditional air. And that opens the way and the routes to
use of this system.
Well, the airplane, yeah, 24 hours a day, let's say.
Yes.
During the night and then.
So downtime will be less.
And for companies, that's also
economic.
Yeah, for the economical reasons. So your plane is not staying on the ground, it's flying. Yeah.
Thank you. Come out nice.